You want to know what the hardest part about being a developer is? Always trying to figure out how to center a div. Not really, I'm just joking, but I know that you've seen the memes. But as your tech bestie, I will not let you become one of those memes. Today, we're gonna cover four different ways to center a div, or any element for that matter. Hey, I'm Bree, I'm a software engineer and your tech bestie who is here to guide and motivate you along your journey into tech. I know we joke about it, but sometimes centering elements on a page or inside of a container can actually be tricky depending on the layout of the web page. So today, let's spend a little bit of time talking about different ways that you can center elements either in a container or on your web page. So all of our examples today are going to start with the same format. We're going to have two divs, and the outer div is going to have an ID of container, and I'm also setting the view height to 100, that way it takes up the whole span of the page. And then we have our inner div, which I just gave a little bit of height and width, as well as a colorful background so we can actually see the div that we're centering. So let's jump right in. So the first thing we're going to do is center a div horizontally and vertically using Flexbox. CSS Flexbox gives us the ability to create flexible layouts that respond to changes in the container size or the viewport size. So what we can do is start by applying some styles to our outer div, and this is basically going to be our container, and we are telling our outer container elements to center anything inside of it. So let's start by adding the display property, and we are going to just say that we want to use flex. This is just going to give us the ability to use the properties that we need to vertically and horizontally center the elements. Next, we're going to use the align items property, and as you see, this is going to vertically center our elements. And then when we combine it with the justify content, if I can spell, property, justify content is going to center the elements inside of container on the cross axis, and that's going to be horizontally. And just like that, with only three CSS properties, we have centered the element on the page. So if we decide to shrink this, we can see that the element stays nice and centered on the page, but it's actually going to stay centered on the element. So for instance, if we change the 100 view height to, let's say, 50, it's going to rise up a little bit to stay in the center of our container element. Next, we're gonna center items horizontally and vertically again, but this time we're gonna use CSS Grid. So like Flexbox, Grid gives us the ability to also create responsive web designs. And if we need to center an element in our grid pattern, it's as easy as only adding two properties. So the first thing that we're going to do to our container is we're going to set the display to grid. And this is going to give us, again, access to those grid properties that we're going to then use to center our element. And then the only other thing that we need to do is add the place self property onto our inner div. And we are going to set it to center because we want the items to be in the center of the container. And with just those two properties, which is really cool, the element is centered on the page. So the place self property is actually shorthand for two properties. And those two properties are justify self and align self. Those should sound pretty familiar because in the last example, when we used flex, we used two similar properties, the justify content and align items properties, to vertically and horizontally center the element as well. So next up, we're going to center a div horizontally only, and we're gonna do this by using a margin. So if you're not concerned with vertically aligning your element, what you can do is actually just set a margin on the element that you're looking to horizontally center, and you can set that margin to auto. So the one caveat here is that it's only going to work on block elements like a div or a paragraph, but it's not going to work on inline elements such as a span or an anchor tag. So why does this work? So as we can see here, we have a width that is set on our div. And what's happening is the margin is basically calculating any space that's not taken up by the width of our div, and it is splitting the remainder equally and then setting a left margin and a right margin accordingly to center our div. And lastly, we're going to center an element vertically using absolute positioning. So if you're only concerned with vertically centering an element, absolute positioning might be an option for you. So to do this, we're going to combine a few different properties together. And this time, since we are not positioning it based on our container, we are only going to be focused on our inner div. And we're going to start by setting the position on our inner div to absolute. Now, this isn't going to give us any visual changes on its own, but the next part will. Next, we're going to use the top property, and we're going to set this to 50%. And this is going to move our element 50% of the way down the page. Now, as you can see here, or maybe I will adjust the height just a little bit so that we can actually see it, even though it moved down 50% of the way down the page, it did not actually move it to the center. What it did is it moved the top of our element down 50%. So what we need to do next is have a way to raise the element back up. And we're going to do this by using a 2D transform. So we're going to use the transform property, and we are going to use translate to move it back up. So translate, yes. So translate accepts two properties, like an X and a Y value. And because we don't want to move anything horizontally on the X axis, we're going to go ahead and insert 0. And then we want to move it back up about 50% so that it's actually in the middle of the page. So in order to do that, we're going to use a negative 50%. And now, as we can see, that actually moves it back up to the center of the page. So if we change this back to 100, it's still right there in the middle. So there you have it. Centering a div isn't that hard after all. Now, I do just want to note, in programming, there are a lot of different ways to accomplish the same thing, and that is no different here. It's all about what works best for you and your code base. So feel free to bookmark this video for whenever you need it, because the need will come at the most random time. But this time, you won't be scratching your head trying to figure out how to center a div. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope that you found it helpful as well. Don't forget to follow me on my other socials, like TikTok, where I typically post daily, and Instagram. And until next time, I'll see you all in the next video.